Cloudflare just launched containers in public beta for all paid plans. And if you're a developer, you need to understand four things: what containers are, why they matter, when you should use containers, and how to get started. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly whether containers solve your problem and how to deploy your first container. Let's dive in. Okay, question number one: what are containers and what are Cloudflare containers? Let's level set. A container is a standardized unit of software that packages up code and all of its dependencies so the application runs consistently across different computing environments. Containers visualize the operating system, allowing applications to run on various platforms, desktops, cloud, etc., without modification. No longer can I use "it only works on my machine" as an excuse for my app not working. So, we have our container, and in our Docker container, we have your app runtime and dependencies, our OS layer, and the file system access, long processes, and any programming language. These differ from VMs. Unlike virtual machines, containers share the host OS kernel, which is much lighter weight. Some benefits include: you can write once and run anywhere, your laptop, production, cloud. And here's what containers give you that serverless functions typically don't: full file system access, the ability to install any software, run background processes for hours, use any programming language or runtime. Think Python data science libraries, FFmpeg for video processing, or machine learning models that need to stay loaded in memory. What makes Cloudflare containers different? Now, traditionally, deploying containers globally meant managing Kubernetes clusters, configuring load balancers, setting up monitoring across multiple regions. It's complex and expensive. But here's what makes Cloudflare containers different, revolutionary, if you will. You can take any Docker container and deploy it directly to our global network. Containers are tightly integrated with workers and the rest of the developer platform, which means your workflow stays simple. Just define a container in a few lines of code and run wrangler deploy, just like you would with a Cloudflare worker. Similarly, containers are global. As with workers, you just deploy to region Earth. No need to manage configs across 5 different regions for a global application. Pick the right tool for the job. Routing requests between workers and containers is pretty simple. Use a worker when you need to be ultra lightweight and scalable. Use a container when you need more power and flexibility. Yeah. Something that I think is pretty cool is that containers are programmable. Container instances are spun up on demand and controlled by workers' code. If you need custom logic, just write some JavaScript instead of spending time chaining together API calls or writing Kubernetes operators. With Cloudflare containers, you can deploy your container image to region Earth without worrying about managing infrastructure. Containers are like getting the power of Kubernetes with the simplicity of deploying a serverless function, but for any Docker container you already have. Question number two: why should I use Cloudflare containers? Right now, as a developer, you're stuck in this frustrating middle ground. On one hand, you have serverless. We have serverless functions like workers, Lambda, etc. They who shall not be named. Some pros include: they're global, deployment, they're fast, auto-scaling, zero config. Some cons: memory limits and time limits. 15-minute timeouts, no file system, limited runtimes. Well, that looks pretty cool. We have traditional container platforms like ECS, GKE, self-hosted. so many possibilities. Pros include bulk power, any language, unlimited resources, complete control. Cons. There's always cons. Complex setup. Manage regions manually. Config. Configure auto scaling. Expensive idle costs. And in between serverless and containers, there's a gap. See the problem? You either get simplicity or power, but not both. If you need to run AI models, process large files, or use specialized libraries, you're forced into infrastructure complexity. This is why so many developers end up with hybrid architectures. Serverless for APIs, separate container infrastructure for heavy work. That means managing two deployment pipelines, monitoring systems, and scaling strategies. Sigh. Why does this matter? Cloudflare Containers fills this gap. So, the Netflix example. Why this matters. Let me show you why this breakthrough matters with a real-world scenario. Think about Netflix's content delivery challenge. Certain movies are more popular in different regions. In the US, for example, we like superhero movies. In Europe, audiences prefer detective shows, some crime dramas. Although I guess those are pretty popular in the States too. In Asia, Asian markets prefer anime. In Latin America, telenovelas rule 90% engagement with romantic dramas. Now, here's the traditional approach. Either cache everything everywhere, wasting bandwidth and storage, or manually configure each region's cache settings, an operational nightmare. Plus, what happens when your user base shifts? You need to serve customers in Brazil suddenly. You would have to provision infrastructure there. Most of your customers are now in Germany. Time to reconfigure your entire deployment. Now, Netflix could solve this by deploying the same containerized application globally, with each regional container running a machine learning algorithm that figures out what movies it should cache locally. Both containers are built from the same Docker image, but each one can intelligently determine which videos to cache for its respective region, making the service significantly more performant. And users won't necessarily understand the technical importance of this approach. They won't know why it matters to cache different videos on the edge for different regions. What they will notice is that their favorite shows and movies load almost instantly, while content that's less popular in their area might take a little longer. The magic happens behind the scenes, where intelligent regional caching delivers a better user experience without any additional complexity for developers. With Cloudflare Containers, you deploy one Docker container globally. Here's the magic. It's easy to spin up instances in any location without having to decide on a region ahead of time. Need to serve things in Brazil? Great. Most of your customers in Germany? Also great. Each regional instance can run its own machine learning algorithm, analyzing local viewing patterns in real time and automatically deciding what content to cache. Cloudflare picks the best location across our global network. We've pre-provisioned a ready-to-go container. So, the result? The popular regional content loads in 50 milliseconds from local cache, while non-cached content take 800 milliseconds from origin servers. That's 16 times faster performance, higher user satisfaction, and reduced origin server costs, all with zero manual regional configuration or infrastructure decisions. Why this matters? You get intelligent, adaptive infrastructure that optimizes itself globally while you focus on building features, not managing servers or predicting where users will be. Why this matters? You get intelligent, adaptive infrastructure that optimizes itself globally while you focus on building features, not managing servers or predicting where your users will be. When should I use Cloudflare containers instead of workers? We have a new request coming in. Ultra fast response. Use workers if you want some heavy processing. Containers. With containers, you can do AI ML workloads or other resource-intensive application that require CPU cores running in parallel. Think image recognition, natural language processing, or recommendation engines that need models loaded in memory. For media processing, think like FFmpeg, video to GIF. You can have video transcoding, image manipulation, audio processing, anything that needs specialized libraries that workers can't run. File system requirements, applications that require a full file system, need to download large data sets, write temporary files, or install system dependencies. Or maybe you have long-running processes, background jobs, data analysis, ETL pipelines, report generation, batch processing that takes minutes or hours. Maybe you have legacy app migration, distributed as container images. You already have a Docker file and want global deployment without re-architecting. Question 4, how should I use Cloudflare containers? This is where Cloudflare really shines. The learning curve is minimal if you already know workers. Let's walk through this code from the blog. We have the container class definition. This tells Cloudflare how to configure your container, what port, when to sleep. It has the routing logic in your worker so that your worker decides when to use the container versus handling requests directly. You have container instances. Each unique ID gets its own isolated container instance with seamless communication. The worker forwards your request, the container processes it, and the worker then returns the response. The session ID here is the key insight. This could be a user ID for isolated environments, a region for geographic optimization, or a task ID for batch processing. The deployment magic. Here's what happens when you deploy. Just define a container in a few lines of code and run Wrangler deploy, just like you would with a worker. Behind the scenes, Cloudflare's platform builds your container image, reads your Docker file, installs dependencies, creates the image, and then it distributes globally, pushes to container registries in 330 plus cities worldwide. It provisions infrastructure, setting up compute resources, but keeping them asleep until needed. It handles networking, configuring load balancing, health checks, and worker to container communication. It provides observability with metrics, logs, and monitoring built in from day one. Your development workflow stays exactly the same. With local development, you can run Wrangler dev, testing workers and containers together locally. During production deployment, run Wrangler deploy with one command for global rollout. Compare this to traditional container deployment. No Kubernetes YAML, no load balancer configuration, no monitoring setup, no multi-region orchestration. It's the same developer experience as workers, but with the full power containerized applications running globally. So let's wrap up by answering our four essential questions. The what? Cloudflare containers combine traditional container power with Cloudflare's global serverless platform. You get full runtime flexibility with zero infrastructure management. The why? They solve the painful choice between serverless simplicity and container power. You can now build applications that need heavy processing, specialized libraries, or long-running tasks without giving up global deployment simplicity. The win. Use them when you hit workers' intentional limitations. You need more memory, longer execution time, file system access, or specialized runtimes. They're perfect for AI ML, media processing, data analysis, or migrating existing containerized applications. The how. The same developer experience you already love with Cloudflare Workers. You define your container class, write routing logic, and deploy globally with one command. No Kubernetes complexity required. So containers are a huge addition to the Cloudflare developer platform. There's a whole type of workload that is now possible to build and deploy natively to Cloudflare. Whether you're running AI models, processing media, or building the next generation of globally distributed applications, the infrastructure complexity barrier has been removed. I can't wait to see what you cook up. Happy building.